Usercentrics.
Welcome to the Usercentrics Web CMP configuration video. In this guide, we'll walk you through how to navigate the admin interface and set up your CMP with ease. Let's dive in. First things first, create your account using your email address. You'll get a verification email to confirm it. Once verified, you can complete the process by setting a password. Time to set up your CMP. To tailor the experience to your needs, we'll start with a few quick questions. Enter your account details, along with a domain and legal framework you'd like the consent banner to apply to. Once your domain is added, we'll kick off an automated website scan to identify data processing services, DPS. Next, choose a preset like GDPR, CCPA, or any of the other US regulations to match the legislation you're aiming to comply with. Now let's configure the consent banner's appearance. In the design section, you can align the banner's look and feel with your website's brand. Choose between a bar, also called banner, or a dialogue, also referred to as wall, and decide on its position on the page. Need a hand? Invite your teammates to collaborate on the setup. This ensures a smooth process and shared ownership. You can always skip this step and come back to it later. Ready to implement your CMP? Whether it's a staging environment or production, you can choose between auto-blocking and manual implementation. We support integration via Google Tag Manager and many other methods, so pick what suits you best. In the Configuration tab, you'll find everything related to your domain and settings. Here, you can see which domain is linked to your configuration and check the scan status. Depending on your plan, you might be able to add more domains too. Based on the regulation or framework selected during onboarding, you'll see additional settings related to legal requirements. Under CMP settings, you can enable features like cross-domain consent sharing, Google consent mode enabled by default, and trigger resurfacing of the consent banner. Want to update the visual style of your banner? Head to the Appearance section. Choose from various templates and features, and decide if you want to publish the changes right away or save them as a draft. Next, set up your privacy trigger and privacy policy embeddings so users can easily review or update their consent. Customize the banner further to match your site's design, and if needed, tweak it even more with CSS. To upgrade the banner's text and buttons, go to the Content tab. Here, you can adjust both the first and second layer content, as well as the button labels. After your site scan, head to the Service Settings tab to review the results. Here, you'll see all detected data processing services, manage scan settings, sort results, categorize services, and decide which to add to your banner. If a service isn't in our database, you can create a custom DPS or map it to a known one. If it's already included, simply click Ignore. You can also create a custom DPS manually via the Data Processing Services tab by filling in the relevant fields. Once that's done, you can also assign related services to your custom DPS. In addition to data processing services, you can manage the trackers and cookies they use. Like with services, you can map or ignore trackers and link them to a data processing service. You're nearly there. The final step is to install the CMP script on your site. You can choose auto-blocking, which prevents non-essential services from running before consent, or manual blocking, where you tag those scripts yourself. Place the script in your site's head section or implement it via Google Tag Manager. Before the user gives consent, no non-essential trackers should run. Once they interact with the banner and click Accept All, those services will load. We also offer quick implementations through Google Tag Manager or WordPress with step-by-step guides to help you through the process. Or if you prefer, you can embed the script tag manually in your CMS or website code by pasting it into the header. After implementation, it's time to see how your CMP is performing. In Interaction Analytics, you can review user behavior, interaction, and acceptance rates by location or device, and even dive into granular data to see which services users are consenting to individually. In Account Management, you'll find a complete overview of your configurations. Here's where you set geolocation rules, manage different configurations, and control user permissions through user management. Want to keep your banner active after the trial? Click on Get Full Access to choose a plan and enter your payment details. You're all set to launch your Usercentrics Web CMP. If you need help, check out our knowledge base or reach out to our support team. We're here for you.